Disappears.
Yeah, let me get around them.
I wish they would make Power Stone 3.
My only problem is, not like Power Stone 1, because it's 1 versus 1. I have a feeling they'd do like a 2 versus 2, make it a party game still. So.
That's fine. I can deal with that, you know. You can play 1v1.
Yeah, I don't know, but the maps are going to be designed for 2v2. Maybe they can make a 1v1 and 2v2 maps. It's a bit compromising.
Yeah, make different maps. They should have like bigger and smaller maps. Because even then, if you're playing 1v1 on like a 2v2 map, and it's larger, then you have a different style of game. That's what VF does, they have big maps and small maps.
But they only go to, yeah, that's true, but I think the 2v2, the Power Stone 2 map was too big, and had too many like goofy like platforms and gimmicks.
Yeah. I don't really dig the platforms,
yeah.
So.
That's why I like Power Stone 1, it's like really close. And the gameplay is like simple, you either throw, you do a homing, like homing jump attack where you throw an item. That's like the mix up. Or swing around a pole. And then you collect all the power stones with the wing thing. And you do instant dirt ball, and it's a homing attack.
So you forgot about that.
Yeah, so you can't dodge it. Really stupid. I've been looking up like a lot of old strategies for like games like Tekken 3 and stuff like that. Just dumb.
Some of them, yeah, some of them are really bad.
Like Tekken 3, it's like unblockable with whatever. Like, Tekken 2, stupid also.
Yeah, a little bit. I played a lot of Tekken 2.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What? Because you just like laser, you just use the laser with double, and no one can dust step around it, right?
Yeah, basically.
Pressing the button is better than just moving around and not
Yeah, we own, our friends own it.
Okay, you like it. Okay, let's go back and hang out. I'll wrap this up.
That's right. No mercy.
So
no free wins around here. Not even if you're three.
I'm gonna propose this to you because it's quite interesting. One day Kevin, Dan, and I were here.
Yeah.
And we got talking about the alignment of players in third string.
Oh, okay.
And so I'd like you to comment on the alignment of different players in third string you have played. Their D and D alignment.
The D and D alignment.
Talk to the camera.
Okay.
I want that video.
Okay. So the D&D alignments of the third strike players from Doylestown we will start with. Diaper Bomb, as we like to, as we lovingly call him, Brian the Big Poo. Is chaotic good? He's good in that he's a nice guy, but he's chaotic, so you never know when something's gonna come out of his mouth. That's how he plays too.
Yeah, focus on their play style.
I'm trying to. I would say Jordan is chaotic neutral. He is true insanity. Flair, Sean Flaherty. He's lawful good. He's the paladin of third strike. He makes you obey the rules. And respect the rules as well. I'd have to say, therapist is lawful evil.
We agree on that, by the way.
I'm sure we do.
I think Flair's lawful evil, though.
You think, no, Flair's lawful good.
I think he
lawful good and lawful evil are two sides of the same coin.
Yeah, but I think Flair cultivates the personality of being lawful good, but I think he's truly lawful evil.
He may, in fact, be a fallen paladin. We don't know. A blackguard, if you will. I think most of the other people fall in the neutral range. Like, I would say Colton, Wonder, myself. We're in the neutral, neutral good, neutral evil. I might be neutral evil. Wonder might be true neutral. Colton might be neutral good. And which one am I missing? Chaotic good? Jordan's chaotic good. No, Jordan's chaotic neutral. Who's true?
Brian's chaotic good. Do you not have a chaotic evil person? Is Dan Bryson chaotic evil?
No, I also put him in lawful evil. I think top players are lawful evil because it's their rules or you die. Like, Dan doesn't care about you
I think Dan is chaotic evil.
No, I think he's neutral evil.
It's entirely possible.
He doesn't care about you at all when he plays. He just wants to play.
He is a robot. That's fair enough.
And we agree that you were neutral evil. Because you don't really care about what else is going on, but you'll do whatever it takes to win. Was that supposed to be super? It doesn't do that much damage. Don't worry about it. Don't take the psychological hit.
No, that's the whole point. Take the psychological hit.
Yeah, it sucks so much, it does so much damage. It's hot over.
Exactly.
I didn't get the dive kick. I wanted the dive kick.
Yeah.
Always getting serious under that chair scooting.
That chair scooting.
I just remembered my car as a tape player. That's what the session.
Well, they've stopped playing drive-by truckers. Instead, we're kind of back to the chill, new wave-ish.
Following the Grateful Dead for the last
2 weeks
and watching my dogs.
That's
why I got the dog.
Because
we got a new dog, so I had...
Throwing up in my mouth.
What?
So throwing up in my mouth.
I hate this person.
Yeah, we've talked about that. So Jordan, I want to get your opinion on this conversation.
What?
One day, Dan, therapist, and myself were here.
Dan what?
Dan Risen, myself, and therapist were here.
Yeah.
Duncan, and we got to talking about the D&D-styled alignment. Third strike players.
Okay.
So I'd like you to comment on what our players are.
Yeah.
Any
I just did it. I just did it. You know what I said you were?
What?
Chaotic neutral.
I was gonna say chaotic neutral or true neutral. I've actually been thinking about this.
I said Brian was chaotic good and you were chaotic neutral.
Brian might be chaotic.
He's chaotic.
I think Brian is lawful.
No.
Yeah.
You have to give an explanation for this stuff, too. You can't, it's just like class.
Yeah, yeah. No, I know. I'm trying to flesh the whole thing out. But I've been thinking about it lately. It's hard because I have a problem with it because, like... I know it's not supposed to, like, I understand the point of it, but good or lawful and good still imply each other to me. Like, because laws are
it's
always...
Like
what?
You're talking about, like, redundancy.
Well...
No, see, you have to think
like,
about...
the contradictory alignments don't make sense to me because laws are laid
you know
down...
What, you know what lawful evil is? Joseph Stalin is lawful evil. Think about it.
Yeah, but then only like 3 people can be lawful evil. You have to be like
you can be
king.
You can be an autocrat. You can be a dictator. There are plenty of dictators. Dictators are lawful evil.
Yeah, I think lawful evil is like
I think of like a gang. Like they have like a creed.
No, that's neutral. Well, yeah,
like the mafia, like a mob boss type guy. But
yeah.
But they're not. They're not lawful, they're breaking the law.
what's the other one? Lawful doesn't have anything to do with the actual laws of a country. It has to do with the code.
Oh, whether there is a followed code or not?
Yeah.
Okay. Then let me rethink it. Brian is...
chaotic.
Yeah, dude, Brian's like lawful good.
Brian, we hit Brian at the exact opposite.
Don't you ever listen to Brian? He's a great guy. He says it all the time.
No, but it's not Brian the guy. It's Brian how he plays.
Oh, how he plays.
Exactly. Exactly. Therefore, Brian is chaotic evil.
I'm thinking about the person.
No, it's the player. The player, not the person.
He's
I'm not saying
evil then.
Yes.
You are.
And he's definitely chaotic.
Yeah, it's neutral evil
and
chaotic evil. Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. You are chaotic.
I thought we were assessing each other's personality.
No, we're assessing the play spot. Don't chaotic. You're definitely chaotic.
Dan is lawful. He's chaotic. lawful good. Yeah, lawful good.
Yeah.
Lawful
good. Yeah. Lawful good. That's fair enough.
If you're saying somebody's whiskey, he always does something risky then. But it's calculated risk reward. Like, he has a game plan. Like, if you say somebody's playing in a full card style, that's definitely awful.
Oh, you think so? Yeah. So he is, but he's definitely not, like, solid, though.
He's not solid.
You know, like, he'll do, like, down parry. He'll do down parry.
Yeah, but that's because he went through the process of choosing a character where he could get away with it.
Yeah, I know.
I think in real life, Brian's like lawful good.
Yeah, but it's the same real life.
Totally
his
great
third
guy.
Strike, not real life.
Did you ever hear him? Oh, then I would put myself.
Also, I think.
Chaotic neutral, probably then.
Yeah.
Jim is neutral. Neutral. Yeah, or neutral good maybe. You don't really try to style on people, which so I can't really think of.
See, I think I'm neutral. See, I think I'm neutral evil because I play top tier and top tier only.
Yeah, playing Chun-Li might be intrinsically evil, that's the point.
It might be.
All Chun players are evil.
All Chun players are evil.
Yeah,
that is what we have figured out, all Chun players are evil.
Argue that anyone who is in a lawful alignment, like, they've gone through the process of, like, setting down some kind of code of ethics for themselves, is basing it on some type of philosophy that they've previously seen, which would imply, like, a good and evil dialectic. Like, anything that I'm deciding is good or evil, like, is based on other things I've seen in my life. Like, so for a lot of people, that's going to be their religion, because it's, like, really influenced.
But it's the difference between, like, a Nazi and a Marine, right? Both have codes, but one takes their code and says, okay, in my code, the white race is the best race, and therefore we have to eliminate all the other races for the benefit.
The extreme
it's for the benefit of humankind. They both think, most lawful people think they're doing it for the benefit of.
That's what the Marines do too. They're like, let's go kill all the fucking Sam N-words. We don't say the N-word here in Doylestown, folks.
Except for Brian.
Even though there's no black people. Nobody just told us. Totally great guy.
Okay, so we got off topic. What's Donish? Is Donish the truest of neutral?
Donish is Pakistani.
No.
I know what you're Donish is. Oh, shit.
Is he the truest of neutral?
No.
I think so.
He's definitely lawful.
I think he's a robot.
He's lawful. Yeah, robots have, like, a code of fucking. Whatever they're programmed to do. They literally have a code of ethics.